Good morning and welcome to the Biomedical Engineering Department at Georgia Tech. We're currently standing in the main atrium and I'm going to be your tour guide for today. My name is Michelle Mandula. So I'll be walking you around the building and showing you some of the really awesome things that we have to offer you here. So in the main atrium space right now, directly above us are a lot of the laboratory spaces as well as some of the professor offices. So all of them are really great. They're really welcoming. All of them are required to have office hours per institute policy, but most of them actually have an open door policy, which is even better. So that means that you're allowed to just go in whenever you walk by and their door happens to be open, and feel free to just sit down and ask them questions about careers or study abroad or class, or if you're having any difficulties in or out of the curriculum area, they're more than happy to help you. Almost all of them work in some kind of laboratory space here as well, which is typically right across from their office on the other side. So it's a really great way to connect with them and ask if they have any positions open if you're interested in doing research. Speaking of research, we actually have about 70% of our undergraduates do research. However, it's not actually required in our curriculum. So if you want to get involved with that, feel free. A lot of the students find that it helps round out and show application in their actual curriculum and helps really bring to home exactly what they're doing and learning in their class. So that's a really awesome aspect of our program. In terms of how that research qualifies into your actual coursework, if you're sitting there saying, well, what if I do that and spend time on it, am I going to get credit? The answer is absolutely. Our department is really unique in that we actually offer a way for you to incorporate other interests outside of biomedical engineering into your coursework, because everyone has something else that they like to do. So we have four different breadth areas that you're allowed to pursue, and you'll get credit for those in your undergraduate degree, because we know that it makes you a better, well-rounded person when you're going to go and join the workforce or do graduate school or whatever. Those four areas include a minor or certificate, which end up being about the same thing. They're just a difference in terms of credit hours, but they're offered in different spaces. So you may have a minor in material science, but you have a certificate in biomaterials. Additionally, you're also going to have an option to do research, in which case you'll work in a lab for three or four semesters and write an undergraduate thesis. Or you can go ahead and do the pre-med designator, which includes a lot of the organic chemistry classes and psychology classes that are going to help round out your curriculum, which you're going to need when you go ahead and apply to medical school. So we offer really great options there, and if there's something that you don't like or don't see, feel free to go ahead and stop in and talk to our advisors. They're right over around the corner, and they're absolutely fantastic. Paul, Sally, Kim, and Kristen are all amazing people and more than happy to do open office hours with you or schedule appointments depending on your availability. We'll go ahead and head over into the atrium next, and I'll talk to you a little bit about some of our different classroom structures. So welcome to our atrium space. As you can see, we have this really nice kind of collaborative learning commons area. We're actually standing in the central hub of where all the student activity occurs. So over on my left side and your right is going to be all of our classroom space currently contained in our building that's not directly below us in the basement. It's really great to be in this common space for a couple of reasons. One of them is that we have a really big community feel in the biomedical engineering department. So you'll see that through all of the posters that you'll see walking down these hallways. There's normally at least two or three up talking about important speakers coming in or when we have a career fair. So that's really nice to be able to see all of those things that they really do to foster and promote the sense of community we have here in the department. We also, in this area, can see all the other buildings that we work with and collaborate with for our department work, as well as with the rest of the campus. So directly over on my right is going to be the IBB building. That's typically more of a graduate research area. So if you want to do any kind of research that isn't in this building, feel free to spread out and go right across the quad. Over directly on my far right is going to be our molecular science and engineering building. That building actually houses our annual career fair that we hold every fall, and typically about 20 or 25 BME companies come in and they'll recruit specifically from our students for internships, co-ops, and graduate programs. So that's really exciting and an awesome opportunity. We also have some larger lecture halls in the basement there for most of the lab classes, just because you'll meet typically once a week together in order to talk about everything and make sure everyone's on the same page as a whole lab section. And then you'll break out into your specific lab spaces, which we'll see a little bit later. Finally, the last building that we have in our quad space is the Ford Environmental Science and Technology building. Currently, that houses the chemical and environmental engineering departments on campus, though they will likely be moved. We have a new building that we just built behind the back of our campus, which you can't see right now, But it's gorgeous and houses a lot of new lab space. So that's really great for us to show that we're growing and expanding, just as we continue to recruit more researchers to come and work with us as faculty. So that's really exciting. The last piece that I'll talk about is some of the items in our cases, which are really promoting our design that we have in our campus. So typically every year we hold a senior design expo in the fall and in the spring, and we also hold an Inventure Prize competition. So the Inventure Prize is actually a large design competition across the entire school. Anyone of any age is allowed to enter a team and a product, and they really help you through that whole product development cycle and really decide if it's marketable or not. In the spring, there's a huge annual kind of end of term competition or showing where it's actually broadcast on live television, and they have everyone come up and talk about all the things that they've built throughout the year and really throw their pitch and say, is this feasible? Is this something that you'd be willing to invest in? The winning team, I think if I remember correctly, gets $20,000 in a free patent application, which is a great prize. Then the second place team also gets a patent application and $10,000, and third place gets $5,000. So, you know, if you're in it just for the extra money, it's a great thing to do. But it really helps show our actual designs that we learn in class and bring them into real life and into potentially full-time production. So a couple of our teams have actually won that, and you'll be able to see that in our cases over on the right as soon as you walk into our atrium, which is really exciting. So the next thing we'll do is go ahead and stop down into some of our classrooms behind me, and I'll be able to show you some of those spaces. So now we're in one of our problem-based learning rooms. So as you can see behind me, all of the walls in these rooms are whiteboard, which means that they're really fun collaborative spaces for you to work in on group projects. Every now and then you'll have a class in here and you'll actually work. Typically the first class you'll have in here is one of your sophomore classes, and you'll work in a large group of eight with a faculty advisor, and you'll work through problems all over these boards. They'll give you big generic open-ended problems like, this is a drug, where is it going to be in 5 years for the same kind of treatment? And you'll have to go do a bunch of research and learn how to read research papers. I know you think you can read research papers, you say I can read, but they're a lot denser and have a lot more content than really matters to you. So they teach you how to do things like find the important content in those papers and go through and really analyze that data in a meaningful way. When there aren't classes in here, you're free to come in here and work on problems from homework or anything on your own. So that's really a fun way to actually have a lot of whiteboard space if you can't find space in the library or somewhere else on campus. But a lot of the students will actually come back and continue to use these rooms through their graduation, just because they like them so much, and it's a great environment to go ahead and solve problems in. So we'll go ahead and head over to our recitation rooms next, and you'll be able to see some students actually doing problem solving right now. So now we're at some of our breakout classrooms. As you can see directly behind me, there's a bunch of students in there right now. So these rooms are typically used for our recitation sections. And if you're not familiar with what that is, normally you'll meet as a large class once or twice a week, but you'll come together as a smaller group once or twice a week, kind of depending on your class, to really practice those concepts that you're learning. So this normally happens for your math lectures, your physics lectures, as well as a lot of our biomedical engineering specific classes. So these are really great for a couple of reasons. The first being that you have a really great chance to have one-on-one time with your professor. So if you have a question about homework or you're really confused about a particular topic, it's a great chance to work with them and have them really sit down and work with you through whatever issues you're having. The second is that you can work with your other students and classmates. So this is a good opportunity to work in typically groups of anywhere between 3 and 6 on a particular problem. So you might actually work through a homework problem. So I would definitely recommend always going to recitation if that wasn't already something that you're planning on doing. And finally, the other nice thing about these classrooms is that everything is movable. All of the chairs and desks have wheels on them, so that allows for a really awesome dynamic classroom feel, which you'll see in just a second, which is really nice so that you can actually get up and move around and turn your sheet of paper or huge pad around all the way if you decide that, oh, this isn't working, and tear something off. So it makes it a really engaging, fun way to learn, and makes it so that when you actually take all these classroom concepts, you can see them and work through them and really get your hands dirty working with all of those things and understand that content much better. Come on with me and we'll head on downstairs so I can show you some of the really cool things in our basement. So now we're in the basement space. So over here on my right side, you're gonna actually see our shop. It's really awesome that we have our own shop down here in the Biomedical Engineering building. What's really great about that is that that means that you can go and actually build anything that you'd like that's made out of metal or plastic. The woodworking is not something that we have the capability for in our shop, but if you want to go over and use the Invention Studio in the MRDC building, which is our Mechanical Engineering building, they have a huge wood shop in there. So you can really build anything that you set your mind to. We also have an electronics bench and some really cool 3D printers. So I would definitely recommend, if that's something that you're interested in and want to get your hands dirty, go ahead and feel free to take some classes, learn how to use the shop. They're more than happy to teach you how to use all those fun tools. If you don't necessarily want to do that in your free time, that's okay. You're still going to have to do it for class. Our senior design class and our sophomore design class actually require that you have a working-ish prototype at the end of the class. So you'll probably be spending some time in that shop. It's really fun. A lot of the people will hang out in there together when they're figuring out different ways to build things. So don't feel afraid to ask anybody about anything that you're currently working on, because they probably have a suggestion as to how to make it a little bit easier. The other space over here on my left is our computer lab space. What's really nice is that we have our own computer lab with all of the software loaded that you could possibly need as an engineering student or for anything else that you're taking for a minor. So just be mindful that you can come in with any kind of laptop you want, as long as it meets the general requirements for the computing software at Tech. And then you'll be able to download anything else onto these computers or have it there already for you that you may need for your classes. So if you're a Mac or a PC user, totally doesn't matter. Use whichever one you're comfortable with. What's also nice is that we have our own poster printing area. So if you need to print posters for your classrooms, feel free to do that free of charge. It'll just get charged to the overall department, which means if you need something for a presentation for research or for another class, just send it on down here and it'll show up 48 hours later, which is really awesome. We'll head down this hallway now and I can show you some of our other awesome lab spaces. So now we're standing in our cellular and biomolecular measurements lab. So if you're the sound of research or doing wet lab work was something that you didn't want to do when I talked about it a little bit earlier, at least in a lab space here, you're going to at least learn how to do those things before you graduate, because that's what you're going to do in this lab. What's nice is that this is a senior lab, so it pairs up with your senior design class. So at the same time that you're learning some of the more advanced engineering principles, you're also going to be applying any of your physiology knowledge in this lab space. So you'll do anything with cell culture in here. You'll actually get to learn how to use a lot of the microscopy and instruments. It's very open-ended, so unlike a lot of your typical math or physics classes, you're not going to have a right answer in a lot of our laboratory spaces, because most of the time, anything that you're actually conducting as an experiment probably hasn't been done before. So it's as long as your process is really evaluated as opposed to the end result. So they're saying, okay, did you go at this in the right manner? Did you make sure to control all your variables and all those kinds of things? So that's what this lab space is really good for. It gives you a nice hands-on technique with all of the laboratory cells, and you actually get to work in groups here. Typically, they're about 4 to 5. So that'll be a nice support when you have to come in and make sure that your cells are still alive over the weekend or maybe late nights during your curriculum. So now we're standing in our systems lab. So here you actually get to apply all of your engineering principles. So whereas we are just in the cell lab and you do all of your physiology in there, here you get to see all of your engineering come to life. There's actually some students over here building a linear force actuator for their laboratory today. So as you can see, it's really a very hands-on environment and really concentrated learning and taking all those things that you learn about forces and all of your momentum and all those kinds of things, as well as any kind of electrical circuits, you'll apply in here. So you do frog dissections, you're going to dissect a heart, really understand how the blood flows through it. It's a really awesome class, and I think a lot of the students really enjoy that part of this, is being able to actually say, okay, well, I learned about it in a textbook, but now it comes here and I make sense of it and I understand, because I built it or I played with it and I really get how it works. The other really great thing about this class is the last module that you'll do. You actually have huge freedom to build your own experiment. The only requirement is that you use some kind of Wii technology using some kind of infrared sensors or pressure. So they give you a lot of fun electronics and remotes and things, and then you get to just go and build an experimental design and conduct it on all of your classmates. So nothing nothing invasive, but everything else is fair game. A lot of the students really enjoy that and have a lot of fun with that last module and Typically, you'll see people in here with punching bags and on treadmills and all those kinds of things towards the end of the semester when that module gets kicked off. We'll go ahead and head over to our senior design lab, which will be the last stop on our tour. So now we're in our senior design studio. There's actually two identical rooms here. So we're on the senior half, and then there's a sophomore design lab on the other side. All of them are equipped with 3D printers, which you can see right behind me. So they actually really encourage you to get your hands dirty and really try to make things and make them work. Every now and then the prints will fail and you'll have to reconfigure however you originally built it. But it's a really good learning process, so you have another tool that you can use, and now you understand iterative design. So let me back up just a second. So our design in our curriculum is one of kind of our three pillars, the first being research, the second being just our general engineering principles, and the third being that design area. So what's awesome about the biomedical engineering design curriculum is that it's two-part. So you have a sophomore design lab, which teaches you how to do all those basic things like draw. So if you're sitting here saying, I can't build something, I can't even draw a circle or a straight line or a cube, totally fine. We'll teach you how to do all of that. We teach you how to draw in perspective. We teach you how to then take those drawings and turn them into something on a computer and 3D model. And then we move from that 3D model into real life with our 3D printers, as well as any of those tools you see in the shop. So it really makes you understand the entire process. And of course, along the way, you're doing some other things like your user discovery and your understanding of your space that it's going to be placed in, all those kinds of things. But I think that's what really gives us this competitive advantage in our any kind of design competition like Senior Design Expo, because we have this phase where we learn how to do all these things before we have to apply them real life for our senior design. Then we move into our senior design class, which is normally taken right before you graduate. And the way it works is you're paired up with a couple of teammates. Normally the teams are about four people big, and you'll end up working on a project that's sponsored by someone from industry or from academia. So you'll get a sponsor, they'll present you with this problem that's very open-ended, and then you'll end up working on that problem together. So that gives it a really great opportunity to go and explore a space that you've never been to before and really get to the bottom of what that problem looks like and create an inventive solution. Because unlike your sophomore design, where you're just redesigning something that already exists for a particular subpopulation, senior design, there's probably nothing out there that fits the problem that they currently have. Otherwise, they wouldn't really be a problem, right? So that's the awesome part about senior design. You then take these and show them at Expo, and BME has a really great history of winning Expo. I think we're currently three or four semesters in a row right now, so it obviously shows that our sophomore design class is working and really building those skills. We'll go ahead and head back upstairs to the lobby.
Hi, I'm Dara Patel, and I'm currently the chair of the Learning Commons. One of the many projects that we work on as a department is to renovate the fourth floor space, which we are currently using as a student study space. We're currently in the process of changing the space from what it's currently being used for, which is mostly group projects and homework, into a space that's going to be a little more collaborative with new design inspiration, with inspiration from other older students, as well as a new digital lab, et cetera, et cetera. The space is currently used as a great way for students to be able to do homework together, to work on problem-based learning projects together, to work on classes such as 2300 or senior design together. And it's a great space to not only hang out with your friends and catch a spectacular view from the balcony, but also to hang out on the bean bags or to be able to work at one of the whiteboard tables. One of the coolest new features of the fourth floor space is our brand new podcast studio. The podcast studio is filled with sound and recording equipment, as well as video equipment that can be used by any student as long as they get proper training. The podcast studio allows students to not only make new videos like instructional Khan Academy type videos that will be later posted onto the BME YouTube channel, but also to record for sound, for music, as well as a brand new podcast series called What's the Buzz that we're currently starting up. It's a great space, and I highly encourage every student to take advantage of it.
So now we're back in the Biomedical Engineering Advising Office. So this is where I'll leave you at the end of the tour. Feel free to send any questions you have to the contact information on our website, and we hope to see you in the fall.